Studio A, Adrienne Watson Carver.
Unmerited favor, favor that you can't earn. You don't have anything to do with it. It's not because you're talented or smart or pretty, it's just because God said so. Okay, so I'm gonna talk about unmerited favor. So there was a lady named Inez Watson who was first Inez Augens, and there was a young man by the name of Earl Watson. Okay, and they met in elementary school. This is my mom and my dad. My mom lived in a house in Baltimore City, and next door was a very special family, and there was a cousin that used to come over to the house all the time in elementary school. And my mom said she put her eyes on that young man, and she was like, oh, he is so cute. And so my mom grew up in middle school, my mom and dad were calling each other girlfriend and boyfriend, because, you know, they did things differently back then. And by 15 and 16, my parents gave birth to their first child. Yeah, my mom was 16 years old when she had a baby, 15 when she got pregnant. And by the grace of God, they got married and they stayed together all these years. And so they had my oldest brother, Earl Jr., and they waited 11 years, of course, to have another baby because they were so young when they had the first baby. And they gave birth to my brother David, then my brother Tony, and then after thinking they could never have a little girl, they had me. Unmerited favor that began before I was born. Yeah, the unmerited favor on my life began before I was born. I remember that one of my most fondest memories of my mother, when I was 4 years old, my mother would hold me on her lap and she would say to me, nobody in the world is more beautiful than you. Nobody is smarter. Nobody is more talented. Nobody is more gifted. And you can do anything you put your mind to. And she would tell me this over and over and over, and I believed her. I believed my mother. And then as I started growing up, I began to play sports, and my mom decided I was going to be a girly girl, but my dad wanted me to be an athlete. So I was torn between both of them. They had me playing sports, but also doing pageants, modeling and dancing, playing basketball, bowling, swimming. I did it all. And my dad would say, be the best. Strive for excellence and be the best, because my dad was a teacher. And so as I'm growing up and I have all this influence from my mother and my father, and I'm going to school and I'm growing up and I have all this influence from my mother and my father, and really I began to see that I was special. And I knew from a very young age, I couldn't put my finger on it and I didn't know what to call it, but I knew that I was special. And I didn't always like being special. And I didn't like always having to be the best. And I didn't always like having that expectation over my head, but I learned to appreciate it. I learned to appreciate it. And I learned to nurture it because of my mother and my father. And then when I got into high school, my mom raised me in church, but I was Catholic as a child. So I knew God was God, but he wasn't really my God. And I know Jesus was the Savior, but yet he wasn't yet my Savior. But then when I got to be in high school, I prayed the prayer of salvation because of a teacher that I had that told me about the Lord. And so I prayed the prayer of salvation and I got saved, okay? And then after I got saved, I started going to church. Me and my brother, we got saved. We started going to church on our own. And then my mother, who had been Catholic for 45 years, leaves her church and comes to church with me and my brother and joins our church, a Baptist church. I said, oh, I'm special. I go to this church, and the church is next door to where my grandmother lived, who was Catholic for 65 years. And my grandmother left her church and joined that church. And so we all got saved. We're all in this church together. And I'm growing up and I'm just moving on in my life. I grow up. I go to Hampton University after I graduate from Wilmore High School. Yay, Hamptonians, baby. Yay. Because I love my school. So I go to Hampton University. I graduate from college. And when I graduate from college, I have all these people in my life. Again, gosh, just sending folks in my life. Wyson Fume was one of my mentors that I met in high school when I did a pageant. He was the MC. And he stayed in my life. So I graduate from high school. I graduate from college, and not too many years after I graduate from college, Kwaisi becomes the national president of the NAACP. And he calls me and asks me, do I want a job? As the national director of the Stay in School program. Y'all, I was 25. I said, okay, okay, I don't know what I'm doing. But I know I'm special. People like, who is this little girl? I was out here drinking from hoses and plowing fields. She don't need to be no leader. I need to be the leader. So I had to work my way through, and I become this national director of the NAACP. So I'm feeling good. I'm feeling confident. I'm feeling like I'm strong. I got myself together. But then I meet this man. I meet this man. And so I have to talk about the major influences in my life. I cannot talk without talking about my mother and my father. I can't talk without talking about my Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. And then I cannot talk without talking about this man. So I meet this man, and I meet him in the gym, you know, because I'm trying to keep myself together, you know. He's in the gym. He's a little cut up. I'm like, okay, who is that? And he comes over to me and he says, you did good. You gotta give me a pound. I said, whatever. He's trying to holler. So we get to talking, we go out on a date, we get engaged, we get married, okay? We get married, and it's a wonderful courtship. I'm super excited. I'm telling all my family and my friends, I met this man. And we're talking about what we do, and we're sharing, and he says to me, you're so talented, you need to leave the NAACP. That's not what you're supposed to be doing. You're supposed to have your own thing. You're not supposed to work for nobody. I gotta pay my bills. Where do I get my money from? So he says, you're not supposed to work for nobody. So I say, okay. So he says, well, I'm ready to go get started. He goes. So I dance, and I model, and I do public speaking, and I train girls in etiquette. This is all the things I've been doing since I was a little girl. I did pageants, a pageant coach, just really empowering girls, and dancing, and enjoying the arts. And my husband at the time, he goes and finds a place. And he said, I found this place, already got hardwood floors, already got mirrors. What you gonna do? I say, okay, I'll just do that on Saturdays. He said, no, come on now. We took all our money out of the bank that we had. We put a down payment on this place. We leased the building. I have no one. No one. I said, well, I'm going to have an open house and registration. 5 students signed up doing my open house and registration. Yeah, so I'm working my job, and I'm working. And fast forward about 5 years in, it starts growing. And I have a job, and this job, the principal at this school that I was working with really starts getting on my nerves really, really, really bad. Yeah, she don't like me. And it was new, because I never had a job where my boss didn't like me. It was new, and it was very troubling. It was hard, and I was upset. And one morning, I said to him, my boss doesn't like me. He said, won't you tell him you're not coming there no more? Studio A. That business that you started 5 years ago, you're going to do Studio A. You tell her you're not coming anymore. And thank God for his prayers and my belief that I could do it. That was 18 years ago. I started Studio A 18 years ago, and today I am in full-time business with not only Studio A Randallstown, but Studio A East, with over 250 students. to grow, but for me to change my life and change a whole bunch of other lives. So now, Studio Way, we are raising the standards of excellence by helping people shoot for excellence and nothing less. We're developing character, confidence, charm, and charisma in every student that walks through our doors. We are awarding scholarships to all of our juniors and seniors. We have already awarded over $400,000 in scholarships. The difference because God said we could, and because I had the power to believe and walk in faith. So I want you to walk in faith because you're special, and you're special, and you're special. Your story might not be the same as mine, but you were called to do something special. And I want you to walk out on faith and find your purpose and walk in your purpose. God bless you. My dancers, the dance was choreographed by my daughter Aaron Carver and Darius.